Don't play games. It isn't a time for avoiding masks. It is now a time for wearing masks.
After weeks of politely asking Sydneysiders to mask up, now it's mandated for shops, venues and public transport.
There is a $200 fine for an individual who fails to comply with the health order in terms of the wearing of a mask from midnight tonight.
We're embracing it. I don't love it, but
we'd rather be safe than sorry.
If you don't want to get fined, just put it on.
I guess if it keeps you safe, it is what it is.
The COVID cluster in Sydney's northern beaches, and now another in the southwest suburbs, have put the country back on edge. Cases have already spread to Victoria, and many of our reopened borders have closed right back up. As the new year began, Victoria, Queensland, South Australia, WA, the Northern Territory and even the ACT had shut their borders to either parts of Sydney or the entire state. It's thrown thousands of travellers for a curve right in the middle of the busiest holiday season.
It was just absolute chaos. The state government called it very early. The police, certainly at the border crossing, were really underprepared.
As Victoria's Jan 1 border deadline loomed, 60,000 Victorians managed to rush back over the border with barely a day's notice.
We had to move quickly because it was based on the health advice about what needed to be done to protect Victoria and keep Victoria COVID safe.
But many remain stranded. Around 1,500 people have already applied for border exemptions, with authorities warning that the processing wait could be a long one.
It will take us at least 24, 48 hours to process those exemptions, and we will deal them in priority order. So people will have to be patient.
But for those stuck, with dwindling supplies and little cash, just how patient can they afford to be?
Well, Daniel Forrest was camping with his mates at the Snowy River and is now trying to get back home to Wangaratta. He joins us now. Daniel, you had no phone reception. When did you find out that the border to Victoria had actually shut closed behind you?
So we had no phone reception. So when we got to the actual checkpoint, that's when we first found out that the border had actually shut, so we had no idea till the actual checkpoint, and we went to show our border permits that we had to get across to back to Victoria, and they said they're not valid anymore, so we couldn't get back across.
And what was that moment like for you?
It was a bit sort of shocking to realise that we couldn't get back, and it was sort of like a bit interesting. It was sort of like tomorrow when the war began, sort of come back to civilisation, and yeah, we just couldn't get let in.
Because you're now caught between the New South Wales border and the Victorian checkpoint. I'm trying to discern where you are. It looks kind of nice. There's some water about. The sky looks sort of blue. Where are you guys at the moment?
Yeah, so we were camping there over last night, but because we're not allowed to be technically in Victoria, we've had to come back out, so I've had to just do a two-hour drive, and we just arrived in Jindabyne. So we're just in the car park at the moment. And there's
right.
The lake in the blind just there. So we just got out of the bush till we hear the call.
So much.
So have you been given any indication of how long it'll be before you can go home?
Nah, we got no indication at all. They sort of said 24 to 48 hours since we sort of lodged the claim yesterday, which was lunchtime. So hopefully tomorrow we'll know a bit more, but we've got no idea at the moment.
And how long can you guys afford to stay in this limbo?
Not very long. We're only sort of 19 on sort of low wages. We can't really stay here too long, so, yeah.
Daniel, did you have second thoughts about doing a phones-free holiday given that the situation with COVID just keeps changing?
Nah, I love the idea. I hate phones, so love the idea of getting out and about and getting out of the city and, just no phones, no communication with the outside world. Just awesome.
What does your mum think about all of this?
She thinks it's pretty funny because she grew up on the Snowy and stuff like that with up in that area, so she knows it well, and it's just ridiculous how we're 10 k's away from the border, we're pretty much camped on the border, and then we weren't allowed back up back across the checkpoint, which is just outrageous.
All right. Well, we're very glad that you do have phone reception. We appreciate you joining us tonight, and 10 out of 10 on the social distancing, Daniel.
Too easy. Thank you, Lisa.
Thanks, guys.
See you.
With so much content online, it's sometimes hard to keep up with it all. And let's face it, who has the time? The project YouTube has you covered with the stories that matter. Hit subscribe for a daily list of the news that you need to know.